From Zaxxon onward, the isometric perspective has held a unique appeal in video games, giving pixels a stylish depth in classics such as Bastion, with its reflections on moving on after loss instead of clinging to the same patterns of destructive behavior. Hakoniwa Explorer Plus takes on the somewhat less sophisticated subject of monster girls and ass, but still uses an isometric perspective. Think a pervy landstalker. In contrast, Landstalker is only as pervy as you make it. Maybe. Before I continue, I'd like to remind you that while this is just a review and I've got much beefier videos, I always appreciate it if you could like the video, leave a comment, and maybe check out what else I've got on my channel. And recently, a high-quality video about the strange horror game Your Amazing Tagachi went live over at my other channel, Mackerel Undercover, which I recommend checking out too. You can also follow me on Twitter, at MackerelPhones, or look at my website, MackerelPhones.com. An impressive first release from Suxamethonium, who seems to be a single person, Hakoniwa Explorer Plus is an enhanced remake of Hakoniwa Explorer. Rather, Hakoniwa Explorer, without the plus, is the beta for the final version now commercially available on PC and Switch. The Switch version uses a different font, but otherwise looks identical at a glance, though the T rather than M ESRB rating makes me wonder if the script has been toned down. Hakoniwa Explorer Plus is an action RPG with EXP, towns, bosses, and all the other RPG standards, with an emphasis on item degradation and inventory management. There is one ending, unaffected by the grudge/morality stat, but tons of optional content. Housing these systems is a crunchy, throbbing, ridiculous isometric world rendered in one square diorama at a time, whose delightful pixel artwork and bright colors are a joy to behold. The player can set the blank cipher protagonist's gender to male, female, or neither, but the last choice simply yields some text saying the player must choose male or female because Hakoniwa has no sprite for neither. The simultaneous inclusivity and denial of inclusivity seems odd. Why not let the neither player choose whichever of the other two sprites they want? Because there seem to be no differences between the male and female characters beyond cosmetics, effectively, Hakoniwa allows this anyway. The female harlot can beat up monster girls and sexually harass men and women with the same results as the male slacker. Tsukimizu even kisses her the same way if you climb the lighthouse without falling. Because I played as a boy, and to avoid saying harlot over and over, I'll refer to the player character as the slacker, but please be aware the alleged hero could as easily be someone else. The varied cutesy and sometimes mysterious music tracks aren't the sort I'd listen to on their own, but are a delight in their place. The composer, Tatsuyuki Yoshimatsu, whom the player can meet and talk to in Hakoniwa, explains that he intended the variety in the music to reflect the diversity of the locations that the slacker visits. For the Desert BGM, I tried making it using instruments from that region. What region? And the Profundum Trench BGM uses recorded sounds of me using a straw to blow bubbles into a cup of water, and I tried replicating the feeling of being underwater, etc., when producing all the BGM. The bricks of each square slice of world rhythmically jiggle, as though enjoying the music. Most characters also bounce jelly-like in leisurely dances, as do the throbbing collectible items, but these are not all that's bouncing. Look, I'm not going to pretend I'm above this sort of crap, but this doesn't look right. Like, are they made of goo? Hakoniwa delivers non-stop crude humor and sexual content with puerile glee. There are no sex scenes and no nudity beyond a bare butt or two, but Hakoniwa is hornier than many erogay. The tone is set immediately with a slacker's only, somewhat unreliable companion being a woman named Tsukimizu, Japanese for school swimsuit, who exclusively wears this fetishized garment. Approaching her from behind shows a dialogue portrait of her butt cheeks bouncing. Outside the starting house, the first characters the player can talk to are MILF and DILF. And the chief conflict in the opening town is that slimes called rockets are dissolving young women's clothes. Rockets drop an item called pervy liquid that the player can use to glue down random NPCs to rob them. The dialogue is utterly silly, with abundant vulgarity. Huh? Aren't I cold? Not really. For an adventurer, you're kind of a pussy. Children speak in all caps broken English. to feeling that everything could collapse at any time feels so thrilling. I love it. The lowest weapon class is Shitty. Some locations the slacker can visit include Twink L Lighthouse, High Ass Mountain, and Fuckin' Marsh. In the original Japanese, Twink L Lighthouse is called Mabui Todai, Pretty Lighthouse, High Ass Mountain is Takai Sanchi, Tall Mountain, and Fuckin' Marsh is Uzai Shichi, Annoying Marsh. The first word of each of these names is written in katakana with an extra syllable to perhaps make the silly name slightly more exotic and place-like. While I might be missing wordplay or puns, the localizers clearly add some fun, as is often the case when a translated Japanese video game has a particularly vulgar script. Hakonawa Explorer Plus, as the title implies, prizes exploration first and foremost. Controls are directional pad and four buttons. The slacker starts in JRPG tradition, waking up, in this case in a house with Tsukimizu. From there, the player can leave First Town to access an overworld map with Dragon Quest proportions, i.e. the slacker is the size of a town. From the overworld, plentiful towns and dungeons are available to sink one's teeth into. For added exploration, each section of the map also contains a mechanically useless secret to uncover, such as a cat who will meow, or a signpost with life advice. Or not. New areas in each map screen can be revealed by clearing certain levels, meeting certain preconditions, and/or talking to townsfolk who mention the existence of new locations. Exploration also allows the player to upgrade the item shops in each town by selling them raw materials, expanding the quantity and quality of available equipment, encouraging repeat visits to towns for more than inns and new dialogue. By the end, there are 9 overworld screens arranged in a 3x3 grid, most with 6 or 7 locations to explore, dense like a fruitcake. That exploration, however, is limited to discovering the locations themselves. Aside from the overworld, most areas are straight paths from the entrance to the exit, with only occasional optional side rooms, usually containing some bonus items. Despite bubbly appearances, Hakonawa features equipment degradation almost as relentless as that in Shadow Tower. There's also an AP bar decreased with each swing of a weapon, so that button spamming risks exhausting the slacker, leaving him briefly defenseless. Like in Shadow Tower. Each attack struck lowers a weapon's durability, and each blow absorbed wears down any cape, armor, or other defensive item until it becomes useless. To those accustomed to the Dragon Quest progression formula, the constant inventory loss may infuriate. However, multiple-use kits to repair and upgrade equipment are abundant, as are new weapons and healing items, which, particularly in the early areas, rain down from the sky, though occasionally one of these treasure chests will be a cute girl in disguise. Usually this would be a good thing, but in this case, she's a mimic who will try to kill you. Limited inventory space forces decisions about which equipment and healing items are worth keeping. Hakonawa's item spawn rate expands the exploration to equipment, forcing the player to engage with many weapon types, including swords, claws, axes, and grenades. Each boss defeated adds more inventory slots, but I was always so flush with items, I couldn't avoid leaving most behind. Something like Alone in the Dark, running over items picks them up automatically, and dropping them leaves them on the ground again, eager to be grabbed. This can make inventory cleaning a nuisance, but at least it's funny. I never had cause to regret dropping any items. However, enforced weapon variety belies what never changes. While later enemies hit harder, no matter how leveled up and no matter how vast his arsenal, the slacker swings or shoots all his weapons with the same button and roughly the same range with roughly the same result. In a short title, however, this shallow combat doesn't overstay its welcome. The simplicity soothes, and the exploration's constant forward momentum prevents battles from becoming a grind. To maintain this sense of progress when there seems to be nowhere else to poke around, Tsukimizu, if asked, drops hints about where new levels await. Hakonawa follows an inverted difficulty curve. Initially, running around Knotternback Forest and losing all my money to Tsukimizu's prostitute loan shark alter ego, I felt defenseless and pressed for cash and inventory space. By the halfway point, the slacker had enough EXP and money that he was borderline invincible. Only a few late-game bosses and the challenge dungeons that demand the player empty their inventory require more than running in swinging. Using extra inventory slots to stock up on medicine remedies any danger. I expect a similar progression would occur in all three difficulty levels. I'm just glad to avoid much frustration. The player's central goal, and this may be a spoiler as the discovery of this point is itself a gag, is to accumulate in-game achievements, no Steam achievements, until the slacker is wise enough to win over a particular fairy in Mundos Arbos. Tsukimizu stores all the dozens of achievement trophies in her 11-floor warehouse. The player earns these naturally over the course of exploration, as rewards for defeating certain enemy ambushes, for example, though some demand less intuitive actions. Achievement hunting doesn't constitute a plot, however. There is no accumulation of story or rising tension. The ending reveal of the boss angel's evil scheme is a joke about the pointlessness of the slacker's adventure. It has nothing to do with anything else that happens. The lack of plot also permits what the marketing falsely claims is an unprecedented degree of freedom, though this freedom is shocking in comparison to, say, what the goody-goody hero of Landstalker is able to do. In Hakone wa Explorer Plus, the player can carry out random mayhem a story-focused JRPG would not permit. As early as the cabin in which the player awakens, instead of asking for guidance from Tsukimizu, the player can engage her in a battle to the death. And please do not needlessly destroy her igloo. Every NPC will fight if pushed to it. For example, in Chilbra, certain conditions cause a man, the completely harmless and innocuous evil dude, to appear. Inexplicably, the slacker can speak to him only with hostile dialogue options, triggering a fight. The dude's murder yields the achievement, "What the hell, man?" He might be the evil dude, but who is truly evil here? If the player's grudge stat is too high, the slacker becomes so hated that everyone insults him or tells him to go die, and shopkeepers refuse to do business with him. Dumped in the wasteland. But there is a way to wipe the slate clean. The ad copy for Hakone wa emphasizes monster girls, quote, waiting to punch, kick, wrap you up, suck your blood, and eat you right up. Most enemies are soft, cute, sadistic girls, enveloping the slacker or squeezing him or covering him in goo. The bosses, their usually larger sprites allowing for more detail, perform actions like squeezing the slacker between their thighs or smothering him against their chests, or in the case of Hades, straight up having sex with him. It's consensual though, as Hades only tries if the slacker asks first. Behold a big-ass octopus. And behold a big-ass octopus. Given the considerable presence of women physically and verbally demeaning the slacker, Hakone wa Explorer Plus may cater to those with femdom inclinations. While fighting monster girls is practically its own digital niche, I would more enjoy just getting hugged and squished by cute girls without the battling them before watching their super deformed sprites sadly pop out of existence. But then this wouldn't be much of an action RPG. Blowing Hades to smithereens seems particularly sad given that she's largely friendly, not antagonistic at all, and only attacks if asked to. I thought defeating her would lead to a little cutscene or something. At least I can enjoy witty enemy names like Woman Drake. In addition, every single boss and NPC pops back up, no worse for the wear, if the player simply leaves the area and returns. If you are, shall we say, cultured, you may be aware that the plurality of Japanese ecchi content tends to put sexual emphasis on breasts. To exactly cater to me specifically, Hakone wa is the rare one to favor butts. Aside from exploration, asses are the primary through line, the feature more emphasized in most of the sexualized boss designs. The slacker triggers dialogue with NPCs by running into them, harkening back to a potentially annoying feature of old JRPGs, such as God Slayer, known as Crystalis in the US. I got a Famicom Adventures video about that too, by the way, wink. If the slacker approaches the NPC from behind, he will instead grab the character's butt, and usually receive a line of dialogue telling him not to. The player can grab literally every non-enemy character's butt, including animals. A Shiba Inu will say, no tail stuff, and perhaps more disturbingly, children's, though the latter seem more confused than anything. That little girl must bench press. In the final boss battle, the boss angel's primary attack is smashing the slacker with her giant booty, which is also her only weak point. Afterward, the boss angel says, "Why do you keep attacking my ass?" And the slacker can choose several possible options, leading to the ending. Ass is the alpha and omega of Hakonewa Explorer Plus.
Actually, there is a secret other final boss, but I won't spoil everything here.
Of course, the true final boss also has a nice ass. A Hakonewa, literally box garden, is a real-life art form. These tabletop gardens may include miniature bridges, buildings, and sometimes figurines, becoming a living diorama packed with detail. Hakonewa have a fairly illustrious history in video game design, too. In an interview with Wired, Nintendo's Koizumi Yoshiaki claims Hakonewa is a part of the design philosophy of the 3D Mario games. Save 3D Land and World, I would imagine, but they hadn't come out yet. The square rooms of Hakonewa Explorer Plus, often full of pixel plants, the throbbing blocks drawing attention to their density and the artificiality of their craftsmanship, are Suksa's digital Hakonewa. Hakonewa Explorer Plus seems like exploitative trash, and it is for sure, but the love and care that suffuse this screen-by-screen forest of Hakonewa and the complete sincerity of a soundtrack that doesn't seem to realize it's meant for a shitpost elevate that trash to something? Hakonewa may go too far in including what amounts to the lighthearted sexual harassment of little kids. But I don't see who benefits by me claiming I don't find Hakonewa, with the exploration, simple action, mild sexual fantasy, cute colors, and pandering obsession with ass, comfy. The downside is that many people who might otherwise enjoy the relaxing allure of Suksa's diorama world will be grossed out and irritated instead. Or is this just the normalization of bad behavior? What does it say about me that I like the nonsense butt hack and slash game more than the fluid animation and family sincerity of solving puzzles and chalk? Am I an unserious person? These are questions to work out in therapy, not here. And if you like that, like, comment, subscribe. There's a link to my website, my Twitter in the description, yada, yada, yada. I make Famicom Adventures videos too, you can watch those, and I make longer video essays sometimes as well. Maybe you could check out my cicada video from a few years ago. Cicadas.